Now in this class we are going to discuss another abiotic factor, soil. The nature and properties of soil different places vary. It may be dependent on climate. First one, it may be dependent on climate and also weathering process, and third one, whether soil is sediment or transported, and fourth one, how the soil development occurs. Okay, the nature and properties of soil different places are vary, so every region you can see. So here in this area the nature and properties of soil, one condition is present, and another area, that means you can go into the another cities and also other states, okay, other districts, you can go and see there are some of the areas are the nature and properties of soil in different places are varied. So all these conditions, it may be depends upon, it may be climatic conditions and a weathering process. Weathering means the soil particles are break down. So here the breakdown process and the soil is sediment are transported, that means it is depending upon the soil particles that can be transporting, that may be also it can be dependent, and how the development occurs. So how to formation of it is the soil formation, there are different methods are present the formation of it is the soil. So the soil formation it will take, it is the number of years. Okay, so that's why here the soil development occurs, that may be dependent. Next, characteristic. The characteristic of soil, okay, mainly such as soil composition and grain size and also aggregation together, okay, all together to determine the percolation, and also water holding capacity of soil. Okay, once again see this point, the characteristic of soil such as soil composition and also grain size and aggregation to determine the percolation. Percolation means so to filtering the water. So the soil having, you can see this is the soil having, you can see these are different regions are present, A, B, C or D also. So the main it is the water can be filtrated, there are different layers, one by one it can be formed, it can be under down, it can be, that means here ground region can be formed the drinking water, that means inland water it can be formed. Okay, so the soil having different regions that can be filtrated slowly, and then finally it can be the lower region can be formed the inland water. Okay, so that means the soil to determine the percolation, filtration, that's what you call it is the filtration, and the water holding capacity of the soil, how much of water it can be hold. So that can be determined with all these characters. Okay, next another point, the parameters such as pH and also mineral composition, and topography, these parameters to determine the vegetation and any area. Okay, so this pH and mineral composition, topography, these are all parameters. So to a large extent of vegetation you can see any area. Okay, that is the parameters. Next one more, the characteristic of soil. One more point, the characteristic of soil, particularly you can see mainly it is a benthic sediments. The benthic sediments in the aquatic region. So to determine the benthic animals and also to live there such an area. Okay, what is here the benthic sediments? Benthic means here bottom. That means suppose in sea at the lower region, that means where it is the flattened region is present, such a region. Okay, that means benthic means it is the bottom. What are the bottom sediments? Sediments means what are the soil particles. So the soil particles and also other components. So what are present such an area? So what? Okay, those sediments to determine the benthic animals. That means the different kinds of what kind of animals are living such an area to determine only these sediments. Okay, so these are the soil features. Once again, see this one. The nature and the properties of soil, different places are varied. That means in the different region you can see the soil having different nature and properties are present. So these are mainly depending upon the climatic conditions, weathering process. Weathering means it is the soil breakdown, and the soil sediment are transported, and how the soil development occurs. So these based upon any area, the nature and properties are, it can be present. Next, the characteristic of the soils, the soil composition and the grain size and aggregation. Aggregation means here a group of particles. A group of particles, all these characters to determine the percolation capability. Percolation means a filtration. So in the soil having different regions A, B, C, D like that present. So this soil can be, water particles are, it can be filtrated. So finally it can be reaches the underground. So that's water we are drinking. So that's why we have percolation capability. That means the percolation character comes from according to this characteristics. And also this characteristics, so main to determine the water holding capacity of the soil. Next, the parameters such as pH and also mineral composition, topography means it is the mountain tops, slopes, all these things. pH, the how much of it is the main soil, it is which one is the better crop for, better crops they are growing. The pH nearly about it is a 6.5 to 7.5. such a pH condition the crops are well growing. And also mineral composition, what are the minerals, are how to formation, so how to absorb these plants. So all these are the mineral composition, and topography, all these to determine the, so a large extent and area vegetation, okay, large extent area or an area anywhere, any different vegetations, okay. Next, characteristics. Characteristics of soil, one more, it is a benthic sediments. The what are the bottom region, the presence of soil, and what are the elements, all these things, this is what it is, the benthic sediments in the aquatic region, any aquatic region. So to determine the what type of benthic animals are present, so that we'll see in the aquatic regions, okay. So this is the features of what is the soil. Next, we are going to discuss another responses to the abiotic factors. Responses to the abiotic factor. Here, during the course of millions of years of their existence, many species relatively reach the constant internal environment. Constant internal environment means within the body only. Once again, this point. During the course of millions of years of their existence, some of the organisms relatively it maintain the constant internal environment. That means within the body. What is this meaning? What is this point mean? During the course of millions of years of their existence. How? Actually, some of the organisms are, they are going to some of the regions. They are settled such area. In an area, you can see, if you are going to such an area, the body is not maintained stable characters. It will take so much of years. Sometimes are hundreds of years. Sometimes are it is thousands of years. Some of them it will take, it is only a few months only. It may be human beings also, it may be most of the animals also. These are the examples. Such animals, during the course of millions of years of their existence, as a result, to reach the constant internal environment. What is the constant internal environment? I will say. The constant internal environment which permits the all biochemical reactions. The body can be permits the all the biochemical reactions and also physiological functions. Physiological functions. These physiological functions to perform a maximum efficiency. Okay, so that permits all the biochemical reactions means what? All the physiological functions means what? So constant internal environment means what are the, these two? That means the constant internal environment means they maintain the constant body temperature, and also maybe it is the osmotic concentration of the body fluids also. That's why such organisms to maintain the constant of its internal environment. For such conditions that permit all the biochemical reactions and physiological functions, and finally it performs in the maximum efficiency such a area. Okay, once again see this point. During the course of millions of years of their existence, some of the organisms are relatively to maintaining the constant internal environment. So such a constant internal environment within the body, this constant internal environment in such a conditions, such a condition means another area, any other countries an area, such a constant internal environment in the organism permits the all the biochemical reactions and also all the physiological functions. All these are within the body show a maximum efficiency. Okay, so what we are living present area in our body, so what you are living such a equatorial regions also, all these are sufficient factors are present. So that's why we will show all the features, that means all the biochemical reactions, all the is of physiological functions, and that's why we are showing you all the activities. That means we are showing a maximum efficiency, everything. It is the respiration also, and also transportation and excretion, digestion, circulation, everything it is can be done. Suppose we are going to another area, the body cannot exist in. So it existed, it will take it as so much of years or maybe few days. So such animals, we are going to any animals or human beings, they are going to another environment, so it will take millions of years later, it show a maximum efficiency. Okay, that's it. Next, the organisms to maintain constant of its internal environment, we call homeostasis. Homeostasis, that means the constant internal environment. Some of the organisms are able to maintain stable of its internal environment. That's we call it as homeostasis. Constant internal environment means here what you call it is main constant body temperature and also osmotic concentration of body fluids. They are maintaining it is a stability within the body. So that's why we call it is homeostasis. Okay, and other organisms cope means survive. Other organism cope in this situation the following features such as first one regulation, second one confirmation, third one migration, fourth one suspend. Okay, other organisms cope, that means survive in this situation. The following features, what are they? It is the regulation, conformation and migration and suspended. Now first of all we are going to discuss regulation.